Sit down, please. Good morning. God bless you.
Buenos días.
I don't speak in English, only little English.
Hey.
Y no sé decir más.
And I can't say anymore.
I love you, Lord. More I love you, Lord. Estamos muy contentos de estar aquí.
We're very happy to be here.
Tony y Gladys ni imaginan cuánto hemos sido bendecidos estos días al estar aquí.
Tony and Gladys don't even imagine how blessed we have been from these days that we're here.
Nuestro corazón estaba unido.
Our hearts have been united.
Pero creo que hemos sido más profundo en estos días.
But I think these days have been more.
Y he disfrutado mucho ver a muchos trabajar.
And I have enjoyed to see many, many work.
Una iglesia nunca va a cumplir sus sueños sin compromiso.
A church will never fulfill the dreams of it without a compromise.
Las iglesias que sueñan y no mueven las manos.
I get angry with the churches that dream but they don't move their hands.
Porque la fe es movimiento.
Because faith is movement.
Y yo veo una iglesia de fe en medio de todos ustedes.
And I see a church of faith in the middle of all of you.
Y ni tendría que profetizar de que Dios va a hacer grandes cosas.
I wouldn't even have to prophesy that God is going to do big things.
Entiéndanme en un buen sentido.
And understand in this a good sense.
Dios está obligado a bendecir una iglesia que se mueve para su gloria.
God is obligated to bless a church that is moving in His glory.
Dios está loco para bendecir una iglesia que se mueve.
God goes crazy to bless a church that moves.
Y ustedes están pasando transiciones.
And you're going through transitions.
Y las transiciones duelen.
And transitions hurt.
Pero las transiciones siempre traerán más gloria y más recompensa.
But transitions will always bring more glory and more rewards.
Siempre.
Always.
Always. Y quiero pedirles un favor antes de ir a la palabra.
I want to ask you for a favor before we go to the word.
Sé que nos estamos conociendo.
I know we're getting to know each other.
Y no es muy educado pedir favores cuando recién conoces a alguien. Calla. Be quiet.
And it's not very polite to ask for a favor when you just get to know each other.
No parece educado pedir un favor tan pronto.
It doesn't look very educated for me to
Pero
ask a favor.
La confianza de hacerlo.
But I feel in the trust to do it.
No es un reclamo tampoco.
It's not also a reclamo. A request.
No quiero que piensen que les estoy amonestando.
I don't want you to think that I'm admonishing you.
No tendría derecho yo a hacerlo, no soy pastor de ustedes.
I don't have that right. I'm not your pastor.
Les quiero pedir que cuiden más de lo que han cuidado a Tony y a Gladys, sus pastores.
I want to ask you to take care of Tony and Gladys, your pastors, more than what you have already done.
Una iglesia que dice honrar a Dios siempre cuidará a sus pastores.
A church that says that they honor God, they will always take care of their pastors.
Y no les reclamo que no lo hacen.
And I'm not saying that you don't.
Les estoy animando a que no lo dejen de hacer.
I'm exhorting you. Encouraging you to do it.
Y que
more.
La medida que más puedan crezcan en ello.
And that as much as you can grow in that.
Espero que lo estoy diciendo con el espíritu correcto.
I hope that I'm saying it with the right spirit.
Amén.
Amen.
Tienen un pastor un poco loco.
You have a little bit local pastor.
Pero creo que les viene bien.
But I think it's okay for you guys.
Hijo de tigre pintito.
And they have a saying in Mexico, as you see the tiger.
Me gusta ver iglesias locas.
I like to see locas churches.
Me encanta la
I know,
alabanza.
Crazy churches. I love the praise and worship.
Gracias por el equipo de alabanza.
Thank you for the praise and
Creo
worship
que debemos
team.
Honrarles con un aplauso.
We have to honor them with our hands.
Hacen muy bien su trabajo.
They do very well their job.
Me gusta cómo cantas y cómo bailas.
I like the way you sing and dance.
Espero que le cantes y bailes a tu esposa también.
I hope you dance and you sing to your wife like that too.
Bueno, luego hablamos en una reunión de matrimonios.
We'll speak about that in a marriage couples retreat.
Norma, mi esposa está aquí, mi hija Hannah.
My wife Norma and my daughter Hannah is here. They're
ayer
here.
Ayer pasó un tiempo con algunas de las mujeres.
She spent a time with us yesterday with some of the women of the church.
Y ella estaba muy contenta.
And she was very happy.
Y con Norma vamos a cumplir 25 años de casados.
Norma and I, we're going to be 25 years of marriage.
Ella me soporta.
She supports me.
Y yo un poquito a ella.
And I do a little bit to her.
Si está llena del Espíritu Santo, es un ángel.
If she's full of the Holy Spirit, she's an angel.
Y tengo que admitir que casi siempre actúa llena del Espíritu.
And I have to admit that she's always kind of always full of the Spirit.
Señor, gracias por tu palabra.
Father, we thank you for your word.
Háblanos, ministranos.
Speak to us, minister to us.
En el nombre de Jesús.
In the name of Jesus.
Amén.
Amen.
En el libro de Corintios, el apóstol Pablo dice,
in the book of Corinthians, the apostle Paul says,
puesto que tenemos tales promesas, limpiémonos de toda contaminación de carne y de espíritu.
Because we have such promises, let's cleanse ourselves for all contamination of the flesh and the spirit.
Pero ¿a cuáles promesas se refiere Pablo?
But what is he talking about? What promises is he speaking about?
Los versículos anteriores hablan las promesas que Dios da a su pueblo. Yo seré su padre y ustedes serán mis hijos.
The verses before that, he's talking about how God is saying, I will be your father and you will be my sons, my children.
Y voy a caminar entre ustedes y me voy a dar a conocer a ustedes.
And I will walk among you and I will get to know among you.
Y esas son las promesas que habla Pablo, de esa comunión de Dios con su pueblo.
And those are the promises that Paul is speaking to, of that communion with God and his people.
Y es ahí en donde dice, puesto que tenemos estas promesas.
And that's where he says, because we have these promises.
Limpiémonos de toda contaminación de carne y de espíritu, perfeccionando la santidad en el temor de Dios.
Let's cleanse us from all contamination of blood and flesh, cleaning us in the spirit.
Ahora, voy a hablar algo que tendremos la tentación de pensar en otros mientras hablo.
I want to talk that sometimes we have a temptation of thinking in others as we hear the word.
Y a lo mejor es válido.
And maybe it's valid.
Pero quiero animarles a que pensemos en nosotros mismos.
But I want to encourage you to think on yourself.
Vamos a ser honestos delante del Señor.
Let's be honest before the Lord.
Dios nunca se mueve sobre corazones que no se abren en honestidad a Él.
God never moves over hearts that don't open themselves in honesty to Him.
Voy a hablar un tema que es muy común.
I'm going to speak of a theme that is very common.
Voy a hablar de la importancia de perdonar y de pedir perdón.
I'm going to talk about the importance of forgiving and asking forgiveness.
Porque todos aquí hemos sido ofendidos y todos hemos ofendido.
Because all of us here, we have been offended, but we have also offended somebody.
Se habla muchísimo de perdonar a quien nos ofende.
We talk a lot about to forgive those who offend us.
Pero se habla muy poco de pedir perdón a quien ofendemos.
But we speak very little about asking forgiveness to those that who we have offended to.
Y si solo ponemos atención en perdonar y no en pedir perdón, terminaremos siendo víctimas.
And if we only pay attention to forgive and not asking forgiveness, we will end up as a victim.
Yo crecí en una iglesia donde desde niño me enseñaron a perdonar.
I grew up in a church that ever since I was a child, they teach me how to forgive.
Cuando me casé con Norma, ella se enojaba mucho porque yo perdonaba muy rápido.
When I got married to Norma, she would get mad very quickly because I would forgive very quickly.
Ella no venía de un hogar cristiano.
She wasn't raised in a Christian family.
Me decía, pero ¿por qué perdonas tan rápido?
And she would ask me, why do you forgive so quickly?
Yo la hacía enojar más, decía, es que yo camino en el Espíritu.
And I would get her more mad because I would tell her, oh, it's because I walk in the Spirit.
Yo tengo que admitir algo. Me enseñó el Espíritu Santo a perdonar.
But I have to admit something. The Holy Spirit taught me how to forgive.
Pero un día Norma me dijo también.
But one day Norma told me.
Admito que tienes un don de perdonar.
She said, I admit that you have a gift of forgiving.
No aplazas perdonar.
You don't take long to forgive.
Te felicito por ello.
I congratulate you for it.
Pero también tienes otro don.
But you also have another gift.
Y el don que tienes es de ofender.
And the gift you have is to offend.
Así es que me replanteé algunas cosas.
So, she took
Yo presumía perdonar rápido.
I would always be bragging about how I forget.
No,
I forgive quickly.
No me daba cuenta que era rapidísimo también para ofender.
But I didn't notice that I was also very quick to offend.
Y ambas cosas debemos ser tratados.
And those two things we have to treat.
Tenemos que perdonar a todas las ofensas.
We have to forgive all the offenses.
Y tenemos que admitir cuando hemos ofendido a otros.
But we have to admit when we have offended others.
Y los minutos que me quedan vamos a hablar de los beneficios de ello.
In the minutes that I have left, we want to talk about the benefits of it.
Todos conocemos la historia de Saúl y Jacob, estos hermanos.
We all know the story of Esau and Jacob.
Esaú fue un hombre que menospreció su primogenitura.
Esau was a man who despised his inheritance.
Fue un hombre tonto y distraído.
He was a dumb and distracted man.
Pero eso no quita que Jacob fue un usurpador y un tramposo.
But this doesn't take away that Jacob was a cheater.
Todos conocemos el día en que su padre trajo la bendición sobre Jacob.
We all know the day when his father gave the blessing to Jacob.
Y Esaú lloraba con rabia y con amargura.
And how Esau was crying with bitterness and he was mad.
Y le decía, Padre, bendíceme también a mí.
And he would say, God, Father, bless me also.
Bendíceme también a mí.
Bless me also.
Y su padre le dijo, no puedo bendecirte.
And his dad would say, I cannot bless you anymore.
Y Esaú, a partir de ese momento, cobró un odio contra su hermano Jacob.
And Esau got a hate against his brother that day.
Y la palabra de Dios registra un versículo increíble.
And the Bible has a verse, an incredible verse about it.
Esaú dijo, va a llegar el día en que se muera mi papá.
Esau said, there's going to become a day when my dad will die.
Y ese día yo voy a asesinar a mi hermano.
And that day I'm going to kill my brother.
Ese hombre tenía odio en su corazón.
That man had hate in his heart.
Y por causa de ello Jacob sale huyendo.
And because of that Jacob flee away.
Llega a un lugar donde conoce a su esposa.
And he comes to a place where he meets his wife.
Pero también conoce a un suegro tramposo como él.
But he also meets a father-in-law that he was a cheater like him.
Si él era un sinvergüenza, su suegro era igual o peor.
If he was a cheater, his father-in-law was worse.
Todos sabemos la historia.
We all know the story.
Pero llega un momento en el que él tiene que partir del lugar donde está.
But there was a moment where he has to leave the place where he's
ya
at.
Ya pasaron 20 años.
There's been 20 years already passed.
Y Dios le habla que tiene que partir de ese lugar.
And God speaks to him that he has to go away from that place.
Le dice, regrésate al lugar de donde saliste.
The Lord is saying to Jacob, go back to the place where you came from.
Y el contexto de lo que vamos a hablar.
And the context what we were going to speak about.
Es que está avanzando Jacob hacia reencontrarse con su hermano Esaú.
Is that Jacob is advancing or going back to re-encounter with his brother Esau.
Y en el capítulo 32.
And in the chapter 32.
Del versículo 1 al 7.
Of verse 1 and 7. Chapter 32, 1 through 7, Jacob prepares to meet Esau. Jacob also went on his way, and the angels of God met him. When Jacob saw them, he said, "This is the camp of God." So he named that place Manaim. Jacob sent messengers ahead of him to his brother Esau in the land of Seir, the country of Edom. He instructed them, "This is what you are to say to my master Esau. Your servant Jacob says, I have been staying with Laban and have remained there till now. I have cattle and donkeys, sheep and goats, men servants and maid servants. Now I am sending this message to my lord that I may find favor in your eyes." When the messengers returned to Jacob, they said, "We went to your brother Esau, and now he is coming to meet you, and 400 men are with him." Hasta el 6 o 7.
Hasta el 7.
In great fear and distress, Jacob divided the people who were with him into the two groups, in the flocks and herds and camels as well.
Imagínense esa escena después de 20 años.
Imagine that scene after 20 years.
Jacob por 20 años tenía la promesa de que su hermano lo iba a asesinar.
Jacob for 20 years he had that promise that his brother was going to kill him.
Y ahora es Dios que le dice regrésate.
And now is God telling him go back.
Pero cuando él envía a siervos suyos por delante.
But when Jacob sends the servants to go before him,
le dicen tu hermano viene hacia ti con 400 hombres.
They tell him your brother is coming towards you with 400 men.
Y el versículo 7 registra que tuvo gran temor y angustia.
And in verse 7 says that he had great fear and distress.
¿Te puedes imaginar lo que había en su corazón?
Can you imagine what he had in his heart?
Tuvo tanto miedo que hasta levantó una oración en el versículo 9.
He was so fearful that he even raised up a prayer. Verse 9. Then Jacob prayed, O God of my father Abraham, God of my father Isaac, O Lord, who said to me, go back to your country and your relatives and I will make your prosper.
Luego en el versículo 11 vuelve a orar, líbrame de la mano de mi hermano.
Then on verse 11 he comes back and pray, free me from the hands of my brother.
Realmente está estresado y angustiado.
He's really distressed and in anguish.
Y en ese contexto es que tiene un encuentro con Dios.
In that context we see that he has an encounter with God.
Versículo 22.
Verse
22. Dice que se levantó aquella noche. Léelo, por favor.
Says that he woke up that night. Verse 22 says the following. That night Jacob got up and took his two wives, his two main servants and his 11 sons and crossed forth of the Jabbok. After he had sent them across the stream, he sent over all his possessions. So Jacob was left alone, and a man wrestled with him till daybreak.
Noten bien.
Notice, please.
En medio del contexto de sentir angustia.
In the middle of the context of feeling that anguish.
Él envía a su familia por delante.
He sends his family before him.
Y escucha muy bien lo que voy a decir.
And listen very careful what I'm going to tell
you. Porque esta es una de las claves en esta mañana.
Because this is a key in the message.
Se quedó solo con Dios.
He was left alone with God.
Hay momentos en que la solución en nuestra vida es en nuestra soledad con Dios.
There's moments that the solution in our lives is our loneliness with God.
Hay momentos en que necesitas amigos, mentores y pastores.
There's moments when you need friends, pastor friends and mentors.
Pero hay momentos en que necesitamos estar solos con Dios.
But there's moments that we have to be alone with God.
Y todos conocemos la historia que viene por delante.
And we all know the story that comes before it.
Se le aparece el ángel del Señor y comienzan a luchar.
We all know that the angel of the Lord appeared to him and they started to wrestle.
Y el ángel le dice, suéltame por favor que ya va a amanecer.
And the angel is telling him, let me go because daybreak is coming.
Pero Jacob contesta, no te voy a soltar hasta que no me bendigas.
But Jacob answers, I'm not going to let you go until you bless me.
Y hemos escuchado muchas predicaciones sobre esto.
And we have heard many preachings about this.
Y las enseñanzas que en su mayoría yo he escuchado respecto a este versículo.
And the teachings that the majority of the teachings I've heard about this verse.
Tienen que ver con oración.
It has to do about prayer.
No me burlo de ello, está bien.
I'm not mocking about it, it's okay.
Pero el contexto preciso es otro.
But the context, the precise context about this verse is another thing.
Muchas veces se usa este versículo para decir, clámale a Dios que Él te bendiga.
Many times they use this verse to say, call unto the Lord because He's going to bless you.
Ruega por esa bendición.
Pray for that blessing.
Pídele tu casa.
Ask Him for your house.
Pídele tu carro.
Ask Him for the car.
Pídele otro carro.
Ask Him for another car.
Pídele otra casa.
Ask Him for another house.
No te haya dado la primera, pide la cuarta.
Even if He hasn't given you the first one,
no.
Ask for the
pide
fourth.
La quinta.
No, ask for five.
Declara.
Declare it.
Habla.
Do it.
Dilo.
Say it.
Lucha.
Lucha por tu bendición.
Fight for your
Lucha
blessing.
Por tu bendición.
Fight for your
Lucha
blessing.
Por tu bendición.
Fight for your blessing.
Pero escuchen bien.
But listen, listen
Eso está
carefully.
Mal.
That's wrong.
Escucha.
Listen, listen.
El versículo 32, versículo 5.
Verse 32, verse 5.
El Espíritu Santo nos muestra que ya era un hombre rico.
The Holy Spirit teaches us or show us that he was already a wealthy man.
Cuando está pidiendo que lo bendiga el ángel del Señor.
When Jacob is asking for the angel of the Lord to bless him.
No está pidiendo bienes.
He's not asking for wealth.
Está a full de bienes.
He's up to the top of wealth.
No está necesitando más cosas.
He's not needing more stuff.
Ya tiene suficiente abundancia.
He already has plenty of abundance.
No está pidiendo más cosas.
He's not asking for more things.
Entonces, ¿qué bendición es la que está pidiendo?
So what is the blessing that he's asking for?
La bendición que está pidiendo.
The blessing that he's asking
es que le dé fuerzas para encontrarse con aquella persona a quien ofendió.
He's asking that he would be having strength for the angel to give him strength to meet with that person that had offended him.
Le está pidiendo, dame tu gloria.
He's asking, give me your glory.
Dame tus pensamientos y tus palabras en mi boca.
Give me your thoughts and your words in my mouth.
Mi hermano está molesto conmigo y prometió matarme.
My brother is offended. He's mad with me and he has promised to kill me.
La bendición que estoy necesitando es que tú me des gracia delante de él.
The blessing that I'm needing is that you would give me grace before him.
Y el ángel lo bendice.
And the angel blesses him.
Le dice, no se llamará más tu nombre Jacob, sino Israel.
He says, your name is not going to be Jacob anymore. Your name will be Israel.
Pero quiero que vayamos al versículo 30 y 31.
But I want us to read 30 and 31st. So Jacob called the place Peniel, saying, it is because I saw God face to face. It is because I saw God face to face, and yet my life was spared. The sun rose above him as he passed Peniel, and he was limping because of his hip.
Note muy bien, Jacob llamó aquel lugar Peniel.
Notice very good, he called the place Peniel.
Y escuchen bien.
And listen.
Le llamó Peniel porque dijo, he visto a Dios cara a cara.
He called that place Peniel because he saw God face to face.
Y fue librada mi alma.
And my soul was free.
Este es un encuentro de libertad para Jacob.
This is an encounter of freedom for Jacob.
No está pidiendo dinero.
He's not asking for money.
No está pidiendo bienes.
He's not asking for
goods. La bendición
goods.
Que necesita es paz en su corazón.
The blessing that he needs is peace in his heart.
La bendición que está demandando es sabiduría.
The blessing that he's asking for is wisdom.
Y encuentra la presencia de Dios.
And he finds the presence of God.
Fue librada su alma.
His soul was freed.
No pierdan este versículo.
Don't miss this verse.
Lo que estoy hablando es una introducción para el golpe final.
What I'm speaking is just the introduction for the last.
Aquí aterrizamos.
Word. This is where we're getting landing.
Versículo 33.
Verse 33.
Capítulo 33.
I'm sorry, chapter 33, verse 33. 33, ¿verdad?
Hasta el 4, por favor. 33.
Jacob looked up, and there was Esau coming with his 400 men. So he divided the children among Leah, Rachel, and the two maidservants. He put the maidservants and their children in front, Leah and her children next, and Rachel and Joseph in the rear. He himself went ahead and bowed down to the ground 7 times as he approached his brother. But Esau ran to meet Jacob and embraced him. He threw his arms around his neck and kissed him, and they wept.
Momento, momento, momento.
A moment. Wait a minute.
Se encuentra con Esaú después de 20 años.
He is encountering Esau after 20 years.
Se encuentra con su hermano al cual ofendió.
He is encountering his brother whom he offended.
Él sigue teniendo miedo.
He still is afraid.
Pero Esaú, quien prometió asesinarle.
But Esau, whom he promised to kill him.
Esaú, quien prometió matarlo cuando se lo encontrara.
Esau, whom he has promised to kill him wherever he encounter him.
En el versículo 4 dice que corrió a su encuentro.
In verse 4 we see that he ran to his encounter.
Pero no dice que desenvainó su espada y le mató.
But it doesn't say that he took his sword and he killed him.
No dice siquiera que le hizo un reclamo por el incidente de 20 años atrás.
It doesn't even say that he was challenging him from the incident of 20 years.
Esaú encontró aquí a su hermano y se echó sobre su cuello y lloró con él.
It says that he embraced over his neck and he cried with him.
Para mí ese versículo es lo mismo que Lucas 15 en el Nuevo Testamento.
For me this verse is the same as Luke 15 in the New Testament.
Cuando el hijo sin vergüenza regresa a casa de su padre.
When the prodigal son comes to the house of his
dice
father.
Dice la palabra de Dios que el padre le salió al encuentro y lo abrazó y lloró con él.
The word of God says how the father goes to encounter the son
y no
and
le
he
echó
embraces
nada en cara,
him.
Solo lo perdonó y lo amó.
And he didn't remind him of anything. He just forgave him and loved him.
Génesis 33:4.
Genesis 33:4.
Es el Lucas 15:20 del Nuevo Testamento.
It's Luke 15:20 of the New Testament.
Es la expresión del perdón y del amor.
It's the expression of love and forgiveness.
Yo noto algo aquí en Esaú.
I noticed something here in Esau.
No está cumpliendo su promesa de matar a su hermano.
He's not fulfilling his promise of killing his brother.
Lo está abrazando y lo está perdonando.
He's hugging him and forgiving him.
En los siguientes versículos Jacob sigue empujando.
And the other verses Esau is pushing.
Hermano, por favor, te traje un regalo, cógelo.
Jacob is pushing. He's saying, Esau, please, I brought you a gift.
Tranquilo, no es necesario eso.
And Esau is saying, calm down, I don't need this.
Quizás estaba pensando Jacob, me daré la espalda y me meterá la espada.
Maybe Jacob was thinking, if I give him my back, he is going to put the sword.
De veras preparé un buen regalo para ti. Tienes que saber que soy muy rico.
And Jacob insists to Esau. He says, I prepare a good gift. You have to know that I'm very wealthy.
Y en el versículo 8, Esaú le hace una pregunta.
And on verse 8, Esau asks him a question. Esau asks, what do you mean by all these droves I met? To find favor in your eyes, my lord, he said.
Lo único que necesitaba Jacob era que le perdonara.
The only thing that Jacob needed
quiero
was for Esau to forgive him.
De tu perdón.
I want the peace of your forgiveness.
Avanzamos al versículo 10.
We advance to verse 10.
Y dijo Jacob.
And Jacob said, no, please, said Jacob, if I have found favor in your eyes, accept this gift from me. For to see your face is like seeing the face of God. Now that you have received me favorably.
Y aquí aterrizamos.
And this is where we land the message.
Con el piano, por favor. Escucha lo que voy a decir.
Listen to what I'm going to say.
Todo este rollo que me eché.
All this thing that I said.
Fue para llegar a este punto.
Is to come to this place.
Esto ha cambiado mi vida.
This has changed my life.
Y puede cambiar la tuya.
And it could change your life.
No porque yo te lo predico.
Not because I'm preaching it to you.
Sino porque la palabra nos lo dice.
But because the word of God is telling us.
Jacob le dice a Esaú.
Jacob is telling Esau.
Acepta mi regalo.
Accept my gift.
Y la última parte del versículo 10.
In the last part of verse 10.
Le dice Jacob a Esaú.
He's telling Jacob to Esau.
Estoy viendo tu rostro.
I'm looking at your face.
Y tu rostro se parece.
And your face looks.
Al rostro que me encontré unos días atrás.
The same face that I encountered some days ahead, behind.
Cuando vio a su hermano Esau.
When he saw his brother Esau.
Cuando le abrazó.
When he hugged him.
Cuando le perdonó.
When he forgave him.
Cuando no tomó venganza Esau.
When Esau didn't take revenge.
Su rostro se pareció al de Dios.
His face looked like God's face.
Cuando miró el rostro de su hermano que lo perdonaba.
When he saw the face of his brother that he forgave him.
Jacob dijo, ¿dónde he visto ese rostro?
Jacob said, where have I seen that face?
Ya sé dónde encontré ese
rostro. I know where I saw that face.
Es el mismo rostro en Peniel.
It's the same face that I saw in Peniel.
Es el mismo rostro de quien me bendijo.
It's the same face that whom blessed me.
Cuando tú perdonas.
When you forgive.
Cuando yo perdono.
When I forgive.
Me parezco a Jesús.
I look like Jesus.
Yo he aprendido algo.
I've learned something.
Estas canas de la barba no son en vano.
These white hairs of my beard, they're not in vain.
Cuando yo era más joven,
when I was younger,
y no es que estas oraciones están mal.
And it's not that these prayers are wrong.
No me estoy burlando de ello.
I'm not mocking
son
of it.
Válidas,
they're valid,
pero insuficientes.
But they're insufficient.
Lloraba, Señor, me quiero parecer a ti.
I would pray before,
Señor, dame tu corazón.
God, I want to look like you. God,
cantaba
give me your heart.
Canciones, quiero ser como tú.
I would sing songs. I want to be like you.
Cuando escuchaba canciones con esas letras, me postraba y se derramaban las lágrimas.
I would hear those songs and I would
push, me quiero parecer a ti.
I would kneel down and I would say, I want to look like you.
Es mi anhelo ser como tú.
That's my desire to look like you, God. And I discovered
que si me quiero parecer a Jesús,
that if I want to look like Jesus,
debo perdonar a los que me ofendieron.
I have to forgive those who have offended me.
Esaú tenía un rostro.
Esau had a face
como el de Dios.
Like God's face.
Porque no se vengó.
Because he did not revenge.
Porque no le metió la paliza que prometió a su hermano.
Because he didn't hit him like he had promised to kill him.
No podemos jugar el juego.
We cannot play the game
de no perdonar.
Of not forgiving.
Entre menos perdonamos,
the less we forgive,
más nos alejamos de Jesús.
We get further away from Jesus.
Cuando perdonamos,
when we forgive,
el resplandor del rostro de Jesús viene sobre nosotros.
The glory and the splendor of the glory of Jesus
cuando
comes over us.
Cuando yo era más joven decía, haz que tu rostro resplandezca sobre mí.
When I would be more young, I would say, I want your face to be on my face.
Cuando descubrí este pasaje,
and when I discover this passage,
entendí que dependía de mi perdón hacia los que me han ofendido.
I understood that it depend on my forgiveness to those that have offended me.
Yo he sido un hombre muy ofendido en la vida.
I have been a man that many have offended.
Tú no tienes idea cuánta ofensa yo he recibido en mi vida.
You have no idea how many have offended me.
Ah, y yo sé que tú puedes decir lo mismo de ti.
And I know you could say the same thing about you.
Yo sé que por dentro dijiste, Alejandro, yo también.
I know that from inside you said, me too.
Nos han ofendido.
They have offended us.
Si perdonas, te pareces a Cristo.
If you forgive, you look like Christ.
Pero ahora vamos con el segundo punto.
But now we are going to the second point.
Versículo 15.
Verse 15.
Esaú se aleja.
Esa leaves.
Deja liberado a su hermano Jacob.
He frees his brother Jacob.
Y lee del versículo 16.
And verse 16, so that.
Al 20.
So that day, Esau started on his way back to Seir. Jacob, however, went to Sukkot, where he built a place for himself and made shelters for his livestock. That is why he places called Sukkot. After Jacob came from Padan Aram, he arrived safely at the city of Shechem in Cana, encamped within sight of the city. For 100 pieces of silver, he bought from the sons of Amor, the father of Shechem, the plot of ground where he pitched his tent. There he set up an altar and called it El Elohi Israel.
Está tranquilo un poco Jacob ahora.
He's more calm, Jacob, now.
Y ahora dice, voy a levantar un altar a Dios.
And now he's saying, I'm going to build an altar for God.
Su angustia se ha ido.
His anguish, his distress has left him.
Su hermano le ha perdonado.
His brother has forgiven him.
Y cuando levanta el altar, le pone un nombre.
And when he builds this altar, he puts a name.
El Elohe Israel.
Elohe Israel.
¿Y sabes qué quiere decir el Elohe Israel?
And you know what these words mean?
El Dios que guarda el destino de Israel.
The God that keeps the destiny of Israel.
Y aquí Israel, aquí Jacob usa por primera vez el nombre de Israel.
And this is where Jacob uses the name of Israel for the first time.
Aquí todavía no existe la nación de Israel.
Here the nation of Israel doesn't exist yet.
Aquí solamente está la persona Israel.
This is only the person Israel.
Cuando él dio la cara a su hermano.
When he gave the face to his brother.
Cuando él vino y se presentó temblando y en angustia.
When he came and fearfully, with anguish, with distress, he came
cuando,
in front of his brother.
Se presentó con valentía.
When he present himself with bravery,
pudo levantar un altar.
Then he could stand an altar, built an altar.
El altar es el Dios que guarda mi futuro.
And the altar is the God that keeps and guards my future.
Cuando tú y yo damos la cara y decimos perdón, lo siento.
When you and I give our face and we say, forgive me, I have offended. I should have not said what I said.
Estaba enojado.
I was mad.
Estuvo mal lo que te dije.
It was wrong what
estuvo
I
mal
did.
Lo que te hice.
It was wrong what I did to you.
Te hice trampa.
I cheated you.
Fui un sinvergüenza contigo.
I was a cheater with
no
you.
Te pagué lo que debí de haberte pagado.
I didn't pay you what I owed you.
Te defraudé.
I betrayed you.
Perdóname.
Forgive me.
Cuando yo doy la cara,
when I give my face,
puedo levantar el altar.
I can build then the altar.
Y puedo asegurar que Dios guardará mi destino.
And I can make sure that God will guard my destiny.
Dale un aplauso al Señor.
Give a hand to the Lord.
Resumen.
And in conclusion,
cuando yo perdono a quien me ofendió,
when I forgive those who have offended me,
cuando yo decido perdonar,
when I decide to forgive,
me hiciste daño.
You hurt me.
Fuiste ingrato conmigo.
You were unjust with
fuiste
me.
Fuiste sinvergüenza conmigo.
You were a cheater with me.
Dijiste que me ibas a pagar.
You said you were going to pay me.
Te escondiste.
And you hid yourself.
Tenía confianza en ti, tocaste mi cuerpo.
I had confidence in you and you touched my body.
Me violaste.
You violated me.
Me dañaste.
You raped me. You hurt me.
Mereces que te odie.
You deserve for me to hate.
Pero yo
you.
He decidido algo.
But I've decided something.
No te voy a aplaudir.
I'm not going to applaud you.
Simplemente te voy a perdonar.
I'm just going to forgive you.
Porque me quiero parecer a Jesús.
Because I want to look like Jesus.
Si yo perdono.
If I forgive, wait.
Si yo perdono.
If I forgive,
la vida de Cristo crece en mí.
The life of Christ gets born in me.
Si yo pido perdón,
but if I ask forgiveness,
yo sentencio un futuro glorioso con él.
I sentence, I declare a glorious future with him.
Te voy a decir un secreto.
I want to tell you a secret.
Porque estas canas no son en vano.
Why these gray hairs are not in vain.
A mí me gusta que me profeticen.
I like for people to prophesy over
me. No
me
estoy burlando ni de los profetas ni de la profecía.
I'm not mocking the prophets
lo
or the prophecies. I say it with heart.
Cuando era más joven,
when I was younger,
me gustaba que me dijeran algo así.
I love for somebody to tell me something like this.
El Señor dice,
the Lord says,
te voy a bendecir.
I'm going to bless you.
Te voy a agradecer.
I'm going to put
voy a
you
caminar
big.
Contigo.
I'm going to walk with
voy
you.
A estar a tu lado.
I'm going to be
tienes
on your side.
Increíble.
You have a great destiny.
Super.
You're going to be super.
Voy a bendecir tu destino.
I'm going to bless your
te voy a
destiny.
Agradecer.
I'm going to make
vas
you big.
A las naciones.
You're going to go to the nations.
Y yo,
and that's the way he was.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. I love you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Bien.
It was good.
Pero descubrí algo.
But I discovered something.
Que simplemente,
that simply,
aunque no me profeticen,
even if they don't prophesy over me,
si yo con humildad,
if I humbly
quitando el orgullo y la soberbia de mi corazón,
take the pride and the arrogance of my heart,
me paro delante de ti,
and I just go before
y digo,
him.
La regué.
Before you and I
la
say
cagué.
Sorry, I pooped. I made a mistake.
¿Hiciste bien la
pooped.
Traducción?
Yes. La regué. La cagué. It's pooped. Yes, I said it.
Se necesita humildad para eso.
We need humbleness to ask forgiveness and admit that we're wrong.
Si cuando pides perdón,
if when you ask forgiveness,
a quien ofendiste,
who, if when you ask forgiveness
no
to those who
perdonar,
you have offended and they do not want to
ese
forgive
ya
you,
no es tu problema.
Then that's not your problem anymore.
Tampoco llegues a decir, si en algo te ofendí.
But also don't come saying, oh, if I offended you in something.
No, 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 decir, yo te ofendí en esto.
No, you have to say, I offended you in this.
Yo dije esto.
I said this.
Yo hablé de ti.
And I talked about you.
Yo te defraudé.
I betrayed you.
Yo te traicioné.
I betrayed you.
Está mal.
It's wrong.
Pido perdón.
I'm asking your forgiveness.
Ruego que me perdones.
I'm begging you to forgive
me. En ese
me.
Momento.
At that moment.
Tú levantas el altar del Eloé.
You raise the altar of Eloé.
Y Dios en el cielo comienza a decir.
And God in the heavens, he
ahora
dances.
Puedo bendecir su destino.
Now I can bless your
ahora
destiny.
Puedo bendecir su destino.
Now I can bless your destiny.
Pide perdón y vas a desatar bendición a tu vida y a tus generaciones.
Ask for forgiveness and you are
going.
Y perdona
y te parecerás a Cristo.
And forgive and you're going to be like Jesus.
Yo he llegado a esta conclusión.
I've come to these conclusions.
No hay dos cosas que más quiero en mi vida.
There's no two other things that I want more in my life.
Que parecerme a Jesús una.
To look like Jesus one.
Y que Dios guarde mi destino y el de mis hijos.
And for God to keep my destiny, guard my destiny.
¿Qué hay más grande que ello?
And my children's destiny. What's bigger than that?
Ni siquiera el servicio a Dios.
Not even the service to God.
Parecerme a Jesús.
To look like Jesus.
Y que Él camine conmigo.
And for Him to walk with me.
Que su presencia esté conmigo.
That His presence will be with me. That His presence will be with my children. This is the top.
Y está en mis manos.
And this is in my hands.
Pido perdón.
I ask forgiveness.
Y perdono.
And I forgive.
Si tú vienes por primera vez,
if you come for the first time,
y tú nunca le has entregado tu vida a Jesús,
and you've never given your life to Jesus Christ,
este es el momento para que tú entiendas que Él te ama,
this is the moment for you to understand that He loves you,
te perdonó,
that He forgave you,
murió en la cruz del Calvario por
He
ti,
died on the cross for you,
y te da vida eterna,
and He gives you eternal life.
Si tú no perdonas,
if you don't forgive,
Él no te puede perdonar.
He cannot forgive you.
Pero si tú pides perdón,
but if you ask for forgiveness,
y tú perdonas,
and you forgive,
Él te perdonará.
He will forgive
you. Y comenzarás a purificar tu corazón.
And you will start
y se van a romper un montón de maldiciones en tu vida.
You will purify your heart and
este
a lot of curses will be broken.
Si vienes por primera vez,
this is the moment if you come here.
Entregar tu vida a Cristo,
for the first time and you want to give your life
levanta
to Christ.
Tu mano ahí en tu lugar,
raise your hand wherever
y
you are.
Quiero entregar mi vida a Cristo,
and say, I want to give my life
vez.
To Christ. You're here for the first time.
En pie ahí en tu lugar.
Just stand. Stand where you are.
Stand, en pie.
Stand where you are if you want to accept Jesus Christ. If you want to accept Jesus Christ, that's good.
Y ahí en tu lugar con mucha valentía.
And right there where you are, very brave.
Vas a decir esta oración.
You're going to say this prayer.
Señor Jesús.
Say it, Jesus.
Tú me amas.
You love me.
Moriste por mí en la cruz.
You died on the cross for me.
Dilo más fuerte.
Say
tú
it.
Me amas.
You love me.
Y tú me perdonas.
And you forgive me.
Ven a mi corazón.
Come to my heart.
Cambia mi vida.
Change my life.
Pon tu espíritu en mí.
Put your spirit in
gracias
me.
Por tu perdón.
Thank you for your forgiveness.
Gracias por la vida eterna.
Thank you for eternal life
que tú me das.
That you give me.
Recibo tu paz.
I receive your peace.
En el nombre de Jesús.
In the name of Jesus.
Amén.
Amen.
Amén.
Amen.
Quienes están cerca de ti te van a tender la mano.
Whoever brought you, they're going to tell you what you did and they're going to help you.
Y gracias por estar aquí.
Thank you for being here this
pie,
morning.
Por favor.
Can everybody stand?
Tenemos tres minutos.
We have 3 minutes.
Venga todo el equipo, por favor,
come.
De alabanza.
The team of praise and worship, come.
Nada fácil perdonar a quien nos metió una paliza.
It's not easy to forgive those who have hurt us.
Cuando a mí me han ofendido, me dan ganas de mentarles la madre y matarlos.
When they offended me, it gives me I feel like cursing to them.
Me siento pisoteado.
I feel stepped on.
Me molesta que me ofendan.
I get mad when they offend me.
Ofensa.
It hurts me when they offend me.
Pero me recuerdo que si no perdono, me alejo de ser como Cristo.
But I remember that if I don't forgive, I get away from being like Christ.
Entonces no puedo caer en el engaño.
So I cannot fall in that false, in that lie
de la justicia propia.
Of the just, that my own just, I cannot come into that lie.
De preparar mi venganza.
And start preparing my revenge.
Y entonces decido perdonar.
And then I decide to forgive.
No dije que es fácil perdonar.
I didn't say it was easy to forgive.
Pero decido perdonar.
But I decide to forgive.
Y siento cuando lo hago que me parezco un poco más a Cristo.
And I feel that when I do it, I look more like Christ.
Y qué bien hace dar la cara cuando le digo, te ofendí.
And it's so good when I give my face and I say, I offended you.
Perdóname.
Forgive me.
Cuando ofendo a mi esposa,
when I offend my wife,
no me gusta ofender.
I don't like to offend her.
Y cuando digo, perdóname.
And when I say, forgive me,
lo digo de corazón.
I say it with my heart.
A veces ella está ungida y me dice, te perdono.
Sometimes she's anointed and she says, I forgive you too much.
A veces tiene sus luchas.
Sometimes she has her struggles.
Me pasa igual.
And it's the same to me.
Pero este es un tesoro en la vida enorme, mía, perdonar y pedir perdón.
But that's a treasure that we have as a couple, that we can forgive and we can ask for forgiveness.
Justo me acaba de echar una mirada profética a la esposa.
She just saw me as a prophet, as a prophet's wife.
Cierra tus ojos ahí en tu lugar.
Close your eyes where you are.
Piensa en quienes te ofendieron.
Think on those who have offended you.
Y otra vez.
And again.
Perdona.
Forgive.
Perdona.
Forgive them.
Es tu peniel.
It's a peniel.
Encuéntrate con Dios.
An encounter with God.
Él es el que da la bendición.
And He's the one that gives the blessing.
Para que aprendas a perdonar y pedir perdón.
So you can learn to forgive and ask forgiveness. Do a very simple prayer.
El Espíritu de Dios está aquí.
The Spirit of God is here. And say, I forgive those who have offended me.
Porque me quiero parecer a ti.
Because I want to look like you, Jesus.
Ahora pienso un poco.
Now think a little bit.
¿A quiénes hemos ofendido?
Who you have offended.
En el momento que ofendemos, ni cuenta nos damos a veces.
Sometimes we don't even pay attention or know the moment that we have offended somebody.
Ay, pero cuando se acerca el Espíritu Santo,
but when the Holy Spirit comes
y nos dice, ¿ofendiste?
And He asks, did you learn something?
Hasta somos capaces de decir, me parece que no.
we even say, I don't think so. I didn't learn.
Que di una respuesta sabia.
I think I gave a good, wise answer. And the Holy Spirit says, nope.
Ofendiste.
You offended.
¿De veras crees eso, Señor?
Do you really do you really believe that, Lord?
Sí, ofendiste.
And the Lord is saying, yes, you offended. You offended that person.
Y lo que no debieras.
You spoke harshly in what you didn't have to speak.
Pide perdón.
Ask forgiveness.
Pero es que, Señor.
But it's God.
Pero es que Dios.
But God.
Pide perdón.
Just ask for forgiveness. And raise up an altar.
¿A quién tienes que pedir perdón?
Who do you have to ask?